Is anyone here for any particular reason to see anyone? You are? You didn't just come to get books and read? Well, maybe. Well, we have one. There we go. So maybe. Okay. I want to thank everyone, all of you, for coming out today, because we're always glad to see you guys here at the library, but today is an especially important day. Okay. We're here to kick off our Reading with the Rays summer reading program. How many of you guys are signed up for the Reading with the Rays program? Okay. Well, I see a lot of hands down. Just so you guys know, you can sign up for it today. As soon as we're done here with our program, you can go up to the desk or the table back over there and get your Reading with the Rays card. This is the ninth straight year that the Rays have teamed up with Suncoast Credit Union, Tampa Bay Times newspaper in education, and the library cooperatives to bring Reading with the Rays to kids in Hillsboro, Pinellas, Pasco, Hernando, Citrus, Charlotte, Polk, Sarasota, and of course, what county is this? The best one of all, right? Okay. So, if you read a total of 24 hours and make it to home plate on your Reading with the Rays card, you'll receive two tickets to a Rays game, and you'll get to go out and see Mr. Longoria in person, okay, playing baseball. But today, he's here in person to read to you guys and answer you guys some questions. So, first, though, I want to introduce Cindy Helton, the Executive Director of Suncoast Credit Union Foundation.
Hi, everybody. How are you? Can you hear me without the mic, or you need the mic? I'm usually pretty loud. Okay, wait. I know you're not here to see me today, right?
No.
Not, I knew it! So, Mr. No, who are you here to see?
Longoria.
What number is Longoria?
Three?
What base does he play?
Third base.
Third base? Did he play yesterday?
I don't think he played yesterday.
Y'all gotta watch. It was on yesterday afternoon. He didn't get to play yesterday, but I bet he's gonna play tonight. We're excited to be here, you guys. We're excited to be able to bring this to you. You know, the other thing that you get when you sign up for Reading with the Rays? If you cover all the bases, do you know what you get? Two free tickets to the Rays game. So you got to get reading. Why do you think it's important to read? Anybody? The little striped little, yes. Say again. It is good for your brain. It's critical. Helps you with critical thinking. Do you think baseball players have to think critically?
Yes.
All right. Well, I am not going to hold this up any longer. So, we got to do a couple things first, a couple housekeeping. When Evan comes up, you're going to have your what on? You're going to have your ears on. How do you think we might be able to get him out here? What should we ask? Please, maybe? All right. So, let's do a little. We're in the library. We can't be too loud. But let's do a little chant. You ready? We're going to go, Evan, Evan. You ready? Come on. You guys got to do this with me. Ready? Evan, Evan, Evan.
Evan, Evan.
Woo! Here you go.
Thank you. Thank you, thank you. All right. I don't need to use this mic, do I? I think, is this one good? All right. Oh. All right. Thank you, Chris and Cindy. I usually have to do the housekeeping stuff, so. I'm happy to not have to do it today, and I just get to read to you guys. You guys excited to be here?
Yeah!
I am too. Has anybody been here before?
Yeah.
Is anybody second time? I mean, not to the library, but with me to read.
Yeah.
You have? Oh, all right. Well, thanks to the ones that have come back to read with me for a second time, and thank you to all the first-timers that are here to listen to me, and hopefully I don't mess up, right? But it's okay. It's okay to mess up every once in a while. All right, I picked two books out today. The first one is a book that was written by a friend of my wife, actually. and I read it to my kids a couple of days ago, and I actually liked the book, so I brought it. It's called Baseball in the Bedroom. And the second one I brought is from the good people at the library here. They picked it out because, does anybody know what this, is it this Sunday? This coming Sunday? Does anybody know what this Sunday is? It, other than Evan Longoria Day. This coming Sunday is Father's Day, so everybody in here has a dad, and you guys should all... Well, your dad's at work. That's okay. Some dads are here, some dads are there. But everybody at one point has a dad, believe me. That's the way it works. And you guys should all show some love to your dads on Sunday because it's his special day on Sunday. So this book is about a son and his dad. So we'll read this one first, and then we'll, because you guys will pay attention to the baseball one a little better. So we'll read that one second. Okay, are we ready to go? I'll try to ask some questions in between to keep you guys interested. But this book is called Every Friday. I'll try to show you the pictures too. The author's note says, every Friday my son Michael and I have breakfast together at the corner diner. Since he turned 3, this has been our special time together and our favorite day of the week. I hope that you, too, will start a little tradition like ours. Friday is my favorite day. It's my favorite day, too. Today's Friday. Sweet. Every Friday, Dad and I leave the house early. Even if it's cold, snowing, sunny, or raining. It's never cold or snowing here. It's always sunny or raining. We see the shops open.
Well, it's raining.
Yeah, but it will be, if it's not now, it'll be later, I promise you. And the building on the corner going up bit by bit. We look at lots of things along the way. 3 more blocks to go, Dad says. Everyone is rushing, but we're taking our time. We get friendly waves, and we give them right back. We count the dogs, and I mail our letters with a little help. Come on, I say, only 1 more block to go. At last, breakfast at the diner. Let me guess, Rosa the waitress says. Pancakes, right? We look out the window and watch people hurry by. While we eat, Dad and I talk about all sorts of things. But soon it's time for us to go. See you next Friday. Already, I can't wait. The end. So you guys understand what that book's about?
Father's Day.
Well, not necessarily Father's Day, but spending some special time with your dad. So, you know, whether it's at the baseball field or at your dad's work or wherever it is, you know, take time on Sunday to spend some time with your dads.
The museum.
The museum. Yeah, we go to the museum all the time. All right, how about I take a question from one of you guys first? Because usually I ask the questions and you answer. But I'll let you guys ask the questions this time. Does anybody have a question for me? Go ahead. How many home runs have I hit this year? I think I have 16 this year. So it's early. It's early. We have a lot of games to play yet. Go ahead, bud. I like your sun hat. That means he came to a game because we just gave those away at a game. Go ahead, you got a question? Is it about the book? Probably not.
If you get to first base, you get a poster.
If you get to first base in the Reading with the Rays program, there it is. Yeah, you get a poster. Here, good question. We'll give you a poster. But you got to get there, all right? You got to read there now. There's your poster. Oh, you guys are on second base already? Great. Go ahead, please. Who's my favorite baseball player? That's a very good question. My favorite baseball player is probably Mike Trout. Yeah, he's probably the best. One of. Go ahead, bud. How many books have I read? I've read actually quite a few books. The last book that I read was called The Girl on a Train. So it's actually going to be a movie soon, too. It's a very good book. It might be a little bit, not advanced, but you know, a little bit, the subject matter might be a little off for you right now, but it's a great book. Go ahead, bud. Say again. How old am I? I'm 30 now. I'm old. I'm an old man. What happened to your elbow? Are you all right? What's that? Oh, we don't talk about it? Okay. Sorry. Sorry. Yeah, you. Do you have a question? Go ahead. Don't be shy. Oh, you're thinking of one. All right. Well, you're next. All right. So think of one, and then I'll come right back to you. And then we'll read this book. Go ahead. How many years? Another good question. Last night, I actually became the longest tenured Ray ever. So 8 years. I've been with you guys for a long time. My whole career. 8 years and 70 some days. So.
I already seen the Marauders.
You what now?
Marauders.
The Marauders? What's the Marauders? Should I know that? What is it? Is that your team? It's a local farm team?
I play baseball.
All right. Do you play baseball? Okay. Well, why don't we play baseball in the bedroom? We'll read this book, and then I'll ask you some more questions, all right? Cool. Good questions, guys. Good questions. All right. We ready? Okay. The foreword of this book says, this book is dedicated with love and remembrance to my brother, Lee, the biggest sports fan I've ever known. Inside a charming southern house on Fair 11 High Hill Drive, Lee's super big-time baseball team used to really come alive. Their players came at breakfast time, they ate their hotcakes, drank their juice. Our mama always asked them please to first take off their dirty shoes. The players in their stocking feet warmed up beforehand in the den. The sofa and the ottoman made up their makeshift bullpen. The batting cage was in the hall. What a dangerous bone breaker. Unless you were fielding balls like center fielder Dusty Baker. I watched as Lee called all the games, umpire, skip, and older brother. He conjured up each game's lineup. He was a dreamer like no other. Lee gave color commentary each and every dreamed up game, and Lee was the commissioner. All of this remained the same. Always rooting for the home team each and every game they played, I'd cheer from right behind home plate until the end of the game I stayed. If the commish decided that winter games would be required, the active roster challenged on and no new players would be hired. Doubleheader days were long and the team was always itching to get to the concession stand, also known as Mama's Kitchen. Lunch was eaten in sock leggings. Mama served PB&J, topped off with a glass of milk, and then the games were underway. They'd be bounding for the bedroom in their stocking feet and all. The stadium was located in Lee's bedroom down the hall. I saw Dale Murphy playing there and once saw Bob Horner too. Phil Negro made appearances, and so did Felipe Alou. Hank Aaron often appeared at 11 High Hill Drive. Lee's home run king, this title will never die. They bunted balls over bunk beds, perfectly pitched over pillows. They made doubles off the duvets and hit home runs out of the windows. They rounded the rug to first base, past our mangy mutt Bo Jin. They ran to second and third base and slid on home to take the win. We would have to change the bags when the cat would slink around. She'd drag us dirty baseball socks and proudly lay them on the mound. Lee would always sit at home base, counting each and every run. Sock feet would always touch the bag, and so the home team always won. Lee and I started to grow up, and our family has moved on, but memories of those ball games will always in my mind live on. Now baseball in my grown-up house airs on a big HDTV, but when I'm cheering on the game, I always think of little Lee. Because of Lee's dream baseball games played in his bedroom down the hall, I'll never forget Lee's home team in their stocking feet and all. That's the end. Does anybody know who Hank Aaron is? I have a prize for anybody who knows who Hank Aaron is. Yeah, very good guess. He is a baseball player. He was one of the greatest of all time, if not the greatest home run hitter of all time. So he held the record for a long time. And I think that's a bobblehead. All right. Nice job. We have a couple more prizes here. Just because I'm giving prizes out doesn't mean you don't have to read, okay? Because this is the stuff you get when you read around the bases. So, for the sunglasses, let's go back to the book. How about this one? We have a local guy on our team now. Well, he's a Florida guy that's actually leading our team in a lot of offensive categories. Does anybody know who that is? He's from Lakeland, Florida. You know, bud? Forsyth is from Memphis, Tennessee. Good try, though. You know? Morrison? No. I think Morrison is from Kansas City. You know? Jackie Robinson's good close. You know? His name starts with an S. And his last name starts with a P. He's got a bald head. Pierce, very good. Steve Pierce. Nice job. All right, how about, I feel like I always ask the same questions here. How about somebody give me their favorite book or the last book that they read and I'll give you a bracelet? Mouse and what? Mouse and the Motorcycle? Cool. What's it about? A mouse on a motorcycle? What's he do? Nice. Very good, man. Nice job. You read one lately, too? Middle School? Cool, and it's called Middle School, or it's in the middle? You're not lying to me, are you? All right, I believe you. Nice job. All right, do we have one more short book? Did we bring the books here? We didn't bring them? Okay. All right, how about a couple more questions? I have one special prize here. It's a signed ball by me. So this is the, let me make sure it is. Yep, it's real. It's real. That's okay. All right, how about, I'll take a couple more questions and the best question gets the ball. So, go ahead.
How did the Rays team start?
Man. All right, you win the ball. I might not know the answer to the question. The Rays have been in St. Pete since 1998, I believe, and they started as an expansion team. So they were one of two, I think, RV, correct me, Arizona Diamondbacks and the Tampa Bay Rays were, well, they were the Devil Rays at the time, and now we're the Rays. So, yeah, good question. Very good. Go ahead. Have I played at the same field? Yeah, we've been at Tropicana Field since I've been here, 2008. So, oh, you want me to read this one? Okay. Yeah, we've been at Tropicana Field since 1999, I think, was the first year there, 98 or 99. I've only played on one team, just the Rays, my whole career. What's that?
How old were you when you started?
Yeah, that's a good question. I've been playing baseball since I was 4 years old. So, that doesn't mean you have to play baseball since you were four to be good. But yeah, I've been playing for quite a long time. So, my dad was my coach for a long time. So, I thank him. All right, should I read this one real quick for you guys? Okay, we'll read one more. Okay, this one's called My Pop Pop and Me. Look, look, my pop pop's a cook. Pat, pat, I love my chef's hat. Scrub a dub dub, clean and rub. Bake, bake, my favorite cake. Sniff, sniff, the lemon whiff. Peel, peel, I love the lemon feel. Pish, pish, the lemon till it's squished. Piff, piff, the sifter's swift. Drip, drip, milk into the batter bowl slips. Mash, mash, I love to smash. Twinkle, twinkle, goes the salt I sprinkle. Sizzle, sizzle, the butter frizzles. Whoosh, whoosh, goes the sugar I push. I push, that's what it says. Plop, plop, the eggs into the batter glop. Tisk, tisk, oh, twisk, twisk, goes the pop, pop's whisk. Anybody know what they're making at this point?
A cake.
Well, some sort of cake. Whir, whir, the bender blender purrs. Pound, 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 the batter goes round. Clack, clack, the spoon I whack. Dip, dip, my finger to the tip. Slurp, slurp, I chirp and burp. Scrape, scrape, the dough, no escape. Pour, pour, that's what batter's for. Blat, blat, goes the batter I spat. Swipe, swipe, the counter I wipe. Creak, creak, the oven door squeaks. Make, make, the hissing cake bakes. So it was a cake. Clink, clink, the dishes in the sink. Slosh, slosh, the dishes we wash. Wheat, wheat, the kettle tweets. Ding, ding, the timer pings. Cool, cool, that's the rule. Slice, slice, a big slice so nice. Yummy, yummy, lemon cake for the tummy. I bop, bop, hop, hop for my top, top, pop, pop. The end. All right. I hear crying baby, so that means it's time. What's up, bud? You got a question?
No.
No question? Just wanted to raise your hand? That's fine. I do that sometimes, too. Have I ever been an all-star? Yeah, I have. It's pretty cool. You got to vote for me now, since you asked. All right, guys, I got to go. I'll take one more, and then we'll run. Here, one more in the back. What's my favorite thing to do when I was a kid? I don't know. I mean, there's so many cool things to do as kids, but I mean, probably playing baseball. I've been doing it for so long, and it's what I love to do. So, thank you guys all for coming out. I hope you guys had a great time. Thank you to the library, to Chris and Cindy, Suncoast. Thank you guys. I think it's very important. I mean, even at the early ages, my son is almost 19 months now, and even if he's not listening or he's just running around the room, we try and just read the books just because they can retain some of that. It's amazing some of the things that I've heard my daughter repeat over the years just reading to her that she's heard in a book, and she may not have really repeated it then or said it then, but she definitely heard it in something that we read to her, and she retained it. So it's very important, I think, to kind of start them on that track very early.
Has being a father changed, your approach to reading at times? And, the experience now reading to your kids, and now is it easier kind of reading into a group of people, kids?
The reason why I did the program, I think, maybe 5 or 6 years ago, and then I didn't do it for a couple years. And when I had my daughter, I got with Rick and the Suncoast and the people that put on the program and kind of told them that I wanted to be the representative again for the program, because I knew that reading was going to be important for me and my family, and it's definitely important for my wife, and she is kind of the one. We have this kind of a big library that we put together now, and just asking people to give books as gifts over the years instead of toys and stuff, and so it's worked out great, and the program has kind of just piggybacked what we've tried to do with our kids and the message that we've tried to spread.
Well, one of the things that the school systems throughout the country talk about is what they call the summer slide, is that, school's out, kids are out and about, and, they don't really encourage reading until programs like this get involved. What would you say to families to encourage them to bring their kids to the library?
Well, I know when I was a kid, especially in high school, we had summer reading, and I wasn't the best at sticking to the program. But I do know that if it was incentivized like it is for us with this program, and not that you need to be rewarded for reading every time, but I think as kids, it's much easier to get them to read and get them interested in reading when there's some incentive behind it, when there's some reason to do it. And so even if you're not getting rewarded, it's important. But I think as kids, you kind of have to show them the way, and sometimes it takes something like this to do it.
Sure, we actually have a couple different summer reading programs. We actually have a Reading Wars program where they can come in and they get a little Star Wars themed bookmark or something like that for reading for kids age 8 to 12, that one's for. Also we have all kinds of programs this year in the library. Usually here at the Central Library, we have them on Monday mornings, but we have programs at all of our different branches, because there's 6 locations here in Manatee County. Oh, there's so many different ways. You can go on our website, which is mymanatee.org/library. You can stop by the library and get a calendar, a handout. A lot of other organizations hand out our information for us, like Whole Child Manatee. And there's just a lot of different ways to find out. You can always just call the library, too, or any of the library numbers. And like I said, there's 6 locations in Manatee County, so you can stop by one and find out all the great stuff that's going on. Well, we want to show them how diverse we are and how much fun you can have at the library, how it's a place of education but enjoyment too, foster all different kinds of arts and sciences here at the library, and really be a part of both education within the schools, but also for kids and teens for their independent education too, and getting involved in the community. Well, we're really thankful to him, because he's such a nice man, and he comes out here, and he's so great with the kids, and he is, as you just said, volunteering his time. He's not obligated to do this, and for him to come out and actually promote for the library like that, that really means a lot to us, to the whole staff here, and everyone affiliated with the county. It just means a lot to us.
You know, this is our third year. We are so excited about bringing this to the Manatee County and to bringing it to the whole community, because it's a great way to get kids interested in reading, for them to continue to read over the summer. It's just a wonderful program. We're excited to be a part of it.
Now, this is a multi-county program that you're involved with throughout the area. Tell us why it's important to kind of outreach.
Well, you know, the credit union covers 21 counties in the state of Florida. So our core is education, and this is right up our alley, and we think it's a wonderful, wonderful thing to do for our community.
Now, this is 2 years in a row that Evan's been back here to Manatee County Public Library, and the turnout keeps getting bigger and bigger. You've got to be really proud, and the library's got to be really proud of the turnout, you know, to salute Evan.
Absolutely. The librarians, they do a great job. They get the community involved. They get the kids in here. They have wonderful summer programs. They should all look into those things and bring your kids down to the library and get reading this summer.
Now, the Reading for the Rays program, that's a Suncoast Credit Union program, is that correct?
It's a sponsored program by us. We sponsor the program for the last, like I said, 3 years, and we're going to continue to do it.
What a great thing to encourage people to read, to get them out to the ballpark. The first prize that went out today was a poster for getting to first base for reading. And, you know, that's going to make you feel really proud of the success of the program.
Absolutely. You know, the winning part is they get two tickets to the ball game. So they got to read around the bases. They get two tickets, free tickets to the ball game. And, the Rays are all about their community, too, so it's a great partnership for us.
One final question for you, Cindy. You see the great turnout for young people and their families that came today. What's the message that you want about reading and the importance of reading for families and young people?
You know, reading is fundamental. You really need reading in any kind of subject that you're going to use. And, again, we're about education, and we just want to bring this to all of our communities.
See y'all.